headed on our way to Florida right now. We did something really cool this morning, which was that we got up and packed on the same morning that we're gonna leave. We've never done that before. Well, I've never done that before. And it was actually really great. I got everything done in 2 hours and I am ready to rock. I'm so excited to get to Florida and just chill for a week. It's gonna be really nice to have a change of scenery. Made it to Orlando. Love it. Brand new. They just opened it about a year and a half ago. And I am so excited to just relax. Showered and in my robe. This is a Sammy and Michelle ritual. We always do this when we get to the hotel on the first night. Wow, this lighting is just awful. Had a good workout, woke up, went to the gym, worked out, had a good breakfast. Honestly, I couldn't eat anything at breakfast except for some gluten-free toast and some bacon. So, cool. I am getting ready for the day. Peekaboo. Doing the last step in my skincare routine, which is good old SPF. Yeah, so I am low FODMAP this entire week. This is kind of like a fear conquering moment for me because, you know, I started my low FODMAP journey a year ago and it was really tough and I stuck with it and my gut did get better. And over time I developed a certain level of confidence in being able to know what I should and shouldn't eat regardless of whether I was in a social setting or at home, etc. And I got to a point where I was confident enough to also give myself leeway when I wanted to and indulge a little bit if it was worth it. Unfortunately, I indulged too much in the move, transitioning to life in Raleigh, etc. Like, it just got a little too hectic and I was just eating whatever I wanted. Honestly, I wasn't prioritizing my gut. My gut really like had a moment where it reacted very strongly. And I was really suffering for a couple weeks and then I decided to get my shit together and officially go back on low FODMAP for a solid few weeks in order to realign. After you go, 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 and you're feeling so confident, you're feeling so capable, somewhere I think I got a little almost like cocky, like, oh, I got this. And it really did break my confidence and it just gave me a ton of anxiety around my gut situation and, you know, it honestly scared me. And so this step in me coming on this trip and doing low FODMAP outside of the house on my own without the meal service is really a step towards conquering that fear and like overcoming that anxiety and like reminding myself once again that you've done this before and you can do it again. You can't let something just, you know, scare you away. And yeah, this week is about proving that to myself and staying true to that and doing it. So here we go. You know, I'm definitely a little nervous, but I think it's gonna be good. I was gonna say something else and I totally forgot what I was gonna say. All right, well, moving on. I recently discovered this like glotion thing and it is bomb. Like, I just legitimately feel like I don't even need to wear any kind of foundation after I put this on. It's like it has a little bit of like illuminating something in it. I don't know all the terms, but is it an illuminizer? Is that what it's called? I don't know. But it just kind of makes my skin glowy, but it's not like a foundation. It's almost like a glowy primer, I would say. And honestly, when I'm home, I don't put anything on top. But for today, because I'm on vacation, I'm gonna put a little bit of concealer on. Hey, good old NARS. Man, this is is just fucking horrible lighting. What the fuck? That's fine. A little bit around the pigmentation, around my mouth chin area. All brown girls know what that's about. And then I recently saw Hailey Bieber do this, and I have no idea if it like does anything, but she does this like line thing around the mouth, and apparently it's supposed to like lift your face up. I have no idea if that's actually true, but let's try it. All right. I am so excited to go to Disney tomorrow. It's gonna be my first time in life actually going to Disney. My husband has gone like to Disney dozens of times in his life. We're just going to Epcot because I feel like that's the most like adult driven park within Disney, because I don't really care to like go do any of like the kids stuff. And honestly, those statues, the like character statues, like scare the shit out of me, so I really don't care about that. All right, blended it out. I don't really feel like my face has been lifted in any way, but whatever. Okay, my favorite step ever is some good old bronzer. I just love the way bronzer makes the face look. I just feel like more alive. I have the bronzer on. Top it off with some blush. See, I just feel like I look more alive. Gonna find a nice spot to post up. Gotta love modern healthcare. Taking my doctor's appointment. Poolside. It's a balmy fall evening. Having a small bite. Shit. We're gonna do that again. Here's my tuna. I'm so excited to try this. It's a fresh.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
This hamachi is epic. I'm so excited to eat it. So fresh, so good. Waiting for the shuttle on our way to Disney. I'm so excited. This is my first time. Epcot, here we come. So I kind of love the fact that it's not sunny. This is like ideal weather for me to enjoy a theme park. Quick history lesson going into the park. Epcot stands for Experimental Prototype Community of Tomorrow. Walt Disney originally thought of it as a actual community where people could live and work in some sort of like utopian society. But I believe the board of directors for Disney back in the 70s decided that that was like a ludicrous idea. And so instead, they decided to make it into a theme park. I got my ears and hey, don't mess them up. And I am ready for a day in Epcot. I look absolutely ridiculous.
No, you look adorable.
We're entering the area where all the countries are, and it is so cute. Headed to France for breakfast. So this was so nice of them. We told them that we were gluten-free. The chef herself came out and explained what we could eat on the menu. That is wonderful service.
think it's really cool that like everybody that works here is like part French.
Yeah, like this is a French restaurant and everyone's French.
Do you think when we go to China everyone will be Chinese?
I mean,
it's a real question.
Gluten-free galette. All of the ingredients in these meals are imported directly from France. What an amazing way to honor a country's traditions and culture by literally bringing everything from there here. That is so cool. Good job, Disney. All right, first bite. Smoked salmon. Santé. Second course.
It's called a banana crepe. Crepe de banana.
Oh my god. That is an orgasm in my mouth. And now we are exploring the French area. I'm just gonna say that I'm in France right now. Veuve and rosé in France before we head out. All right, so now we are entering Morocco. Let's see if I find Aladdin and Jasmine in here. Also, open container is allowed at Epcot, which is amazing. Now we're entering Italy. This is a little preview of what we're gonna see in real life in January. I'm so excited. Here we are in Germany. All right, we're headed into China.
This is called the Golden Gate Bridge.
Say that
again? No, it's not.
Taking a little stroll in the Chinese garden, or like some fake version of the Chinese garden. Okay, so some countries are really, really cool, and then other countries just feel really racist and stereotypical, and that's what China feels like. Alright, Michelle, what kind of fortune are you trying to get in 2023? As we walk into the House of Fortune today.
Good health, wealth, and wisdom.
Can we take your picture?
So cheesy. Actually a really enjoyable video. I loved it. I felt like I was in China.
Like 2001.
A surround theater. It was a circular theater, so you felt like you were in China.
You just visited China in 2001.
Absolutely beautiful. But yeah, the video was quite dated. It looked like it was definitely from
China. Must have been dope 20 years ago.
Entering Norway. Michelle, how do you feel in Mexico?
I feel good. I feel at home.
Okay, so now we're inside the Mexican Aztec pyramid, and it's like a massive celebration of Dia de los Muertos. This is so cool. It's like nighttime in Mexico, but it's like 2 p.m. outside. I kind of feel like I'm in the Coco movie right now. This is like the celebration at the beginning of Coco. Should we do a tequila shot?
I'm down.
Welcome to Japan. Arigato.
Arigato.
I'm mixing cultures by taking my tequila soda into Japan.
Bienvenido.
What are we gonna get?
Sushi. Sashimi. Nigiri.
We are about to take the
Elsa Frozen Ever After ride in Norway. Vishal is trying so hard to be excited, but I'm genuinely excited.
Frozen I like.
It's nice having a human pillow.
So freaking bored waiting in line.
Alright, so I'm coming to the conclusion that I am not cut out for Disney. I absolutely hate it. We've been waiting for over 70 minutes to go on a ride, and what the fuck is the point?
We finally made it to the end of the line. Here we go! Wow! Starting so fast.
We just finished the Elsa Frozen ride and we waited 95 minutes for it and it was absolutely boring. It was so incredibly boring. Oh my god, I wouldn't recommend it to anybody. We couldn't do Guardians of the Galaxy, so instead we're doing Spaceship Earth.
This whole Disney experience is not really for me. I love the concept of Disney. I really don't enjoy this park vibe. I just want to visit all these countries. I mean, I'm glad I came. I'm definitely glad I came one time. Yeah.
Checking out the hotel. We had an amazing morning at the spa, relaxing. The spa massage was actually really, really good. The lady gave me perfect pressure. I got a wonderful scalp massage as well. So now we are ready to complete our staycation and head over to meet up with the fans.